God's modern dispensation now shines as a brilliant ensign to the nations, just as the prophets foretold. But as it shines, opposition grows. As truth is spread abroad, deceit and dishonesty arise to oppose it. As virtue is taught by the servants of God, unchastity increases among the ungodly. This is not a war for territory or wealth. It is a contest for the eternal souls of men and women, boys and girls, the literal offspring of God, our Heavenly Father. Our task is to save all who will listen. God's work and glory are the same, to bring to pass the immortality and eternal life of man. We work together in partnership with Him. We wage no common war, cope with no common foe. The enemy's awake. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Our ensign to the world is floating proudly now. No coward bears our flag. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Seduction is his greatest weapon. Do we realize that? I repeat, seduction is the greatest weapon of the devil. It is alluring. It falsely appears to be advantageous and desirable. He would have us think that bitter is sweet, that black is white, that sin is acceptable, that virtue is obsolete, archaic, and crude. He says that evil is good and that standards have been relaxed. Go your way, he says. Fear no consequences. Do your own thing. Have fun. Express your basest desires if you wish. Let yourselves go. That is his philosophy. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Right now is the time to show. We ask it fearlessly. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? We wage no common war, cope with no common foe. The enemy's awake. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Our ensign to the world is floating proudly now. No coward bears our flag. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? If we do know what is right, have we the courage to stand up for it, to defend virtue, to declare the validity of our faith, to oppose false teachings, and fight the unpopular battle? Have we the moral stamina to confront any and all opposition and thus preserve truth, uphold cleanliness, and defend the cause of God? Every father must waken to the responsibility which is his. Every mother must put her priorities where they belong. Is it too much to ask that parents deliberately and objectively teach their children the gospel truths which alone can save them from the carnage of Satan? Is it too much to ask all parents to live those truths themselves? Is it too much to set a proper example by our own righteous living? Is it too much to teach our children that it is better to die in defense of virtue than to lose it? Is it too much to keep in mind, and may we never forget, that if we receive the commandments with a doubtful heart, we shall be condemned. We wage no common war, cope with no common foe. The enemy's awake. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Our ensign to the world is floating proudly now. No coward bears our flag. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? There is no reward for half-hearted obedience. We must become vigorous and enthusiastic about living our religion. For God commands that we serve Him with all our heart, with all our might, with all our strength, and with the very best of our intelligence. We wage no common war, cope with no common foe. The enemy's awake. Who's on the Lord's side? Who? Our ensign to the world is floating proudly now. No coward bears our flag. Who's on the Lord's side? Who?